ladies and gentlemen, Miss Lena Martell.
Everyone, may I say welcome, and may I also say how great it is to be here tonight. As you know, it's never easy, it's never an easy thing to say what you mean or what you feel to someone you love. So I'm very glad that we have songwriters to help us.
You are
Ladies and gentlemen, today there are many phrases that have become commonplace, things like man's inhumanity to man, which is true, I'm afraid, but my first guests this evening have chosen a name that I think fits our life and times as we know them today, coupled with some happy music that has entertained many, many people for quite some time. We have tonight the Brotherhood of Man. Thank you.
Everything I do, now the time is moving on, and I really should be gone, but you keep me hanging on for one more smile. I love you,
I love
you, oh I, with your cute little way, will you promise that you'll say your
kisses for me, say all your kisses for me, bye bye.
I'll soon be back for more.
This is for me, say for you. This is for me. So long, honey, so long. Hang on, baby, hang on.
Don't you dare me to stay, 'cause you know I'll have to say that I've got to work each day, and that's why I go away. But I count the seconds till I'm home. I love you,
I love you,
it's true, are so cute, honey dear. Won't you save them up for me? Your
kisses for me, save all your kisses for me. Bye-bye, baby, bye-bye. Don't cry, honey, don't cry.
Gonna walk out the door, that I'll soon be back for more.
Kisses for me, save all your kisses for me.
You know you've got to say your
kisses for me. Say all your kisses for me. Bye-bye, baby, bye-bye. Don't cry, honey, don't cry.
Won't you save them for me, even though you're only three?
Thank you. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Well, we'd like to sing now our new record, Angelo.
Lived a young shepherd boy, Angelo, who met a young girl and he loved her so. Rich was she, came from a very high family. Angelo knew it could never be. They ran away to their destiny. Shepherd boy Angelo, who met a young girl and he loved her so.
They saw.
their furious flights. And there's even romance in the way that they dance to the sound of the lights. What a beautiful noise. It's a sound that I love. It makes me feel good, like a hand in a glove. Yes, it does. Yes, it does. What a beautiful noise. Full of joy and of strife. Like the symphony played on a passing parade. It's the music of life. What a beautiful noise. It makes me feel good. It makes me feel good. Like a hand in a glove. Yes, it does. Yes, it does. What a beautiful noise. That was a beautiful noise from the ladies and gentlemen of the orchestra. I thank them once again. I first sang that song, ladies and gentlemen, in America when I was doing a tour of the States. And of course, it's always a wonderful experience to tour America. You know, the big cities, because I now live in a small town. Well, it is a very small town. It's so small they closed the zoo when the duck died, but when I visit a big city, you know, I say to myself, well, but Chicago, I'm afraid I might get mugged. So I'm smart, you see. I'm from Scotland, I'm smart. So I put my money down my sock, and a midget picked my ankle. You never learn, see? You're smiling. Smile with you. You know, it's not always easy to smile, ladies and gentlemen. But if you have difficulty this evening smiling, laughing, we have a gentleman here who might remedy that, because he is the funniest man in the country. In the towns, in the country, he's... Ladies and gentlemen, the funniest man in the world, Mr. Les Dawson.
It is written in the lost book of the old ones. There a voice thundered from the celestial depths of the heavens and said to the peoples of the earth, your perfidy, your avarice, your adulation of false gods, the seas will boil, the earth's crust will be rent asunder by slivers of fire, and life as we know it will become as dust. The rest of the night will be fine with scattered showers. Talking about laugh, I thought he'd never start. You may have gathered by that fun-filled gobbet that my act starts off very slowly, then it grinds to a halt. But before that happens, in an effort to prove that my act is incredibly versatile, intellectual, as well as boring, I'm going to play the piano for you. I had intended to play a little something from Mozart, but I don't see why I should, because he never plays any of mine. And then I toyed with the idea of playing for you Pavane's Pavane for Infant Defunct by Raphael. The only trouble is I can't remember if it is a tune or a Latin prescription for chilblains. So instead, with your kind indulgence, I should like to play a song that was written by one of Scotland's great, but alas, forgotten composers. And I refer, of course, to Mustapha Leakey, the Paisley dwarf who was the first man to discover that people who ate prunes were never late for work. This wonderful little man, and he was a little man, in fact he had turnips on his underpants, never smoked, never drank, never went out with women, he made all his own frocks. And in 1939, in Aberdeen, he crossed a goat with an owl and produced the very first hootenanny. Despite his size, he was a well-known mountaineer, famous for having once been trapped 23,000 feet up the side of Mount Everest on a 2-inch ledge, carrying his lame mule to safety on the back of a bricklayer's hob. You and I, in our inexperience, would have panicked. But he didn't. He fell off. During the war, he was dropped behind enemy lines with a length of rubber tube and some radishes. The idea was to put the wind up Hitler. He was captured in the arms of a frump in Dusseldorf, and when they realized that he had Scottish blood flowing in his veins, the Germans tortured him in the most fiendish manner. He nailed his foot to a plank and played a Jimmy Shan record. He returned to this country, a broken man, and became a meat pie reviver for British Railways. It was while on sick leave in Birmingham after being bitten by a Cornish pasty that he met the woman who was to become his life partner. She was working in a discount store in Birmingham. He went in for a lampshade, and he said, what would you take off for cash? He said, everything but my earrings. It wasn't a happy marriage. She was a big woman. In fact, she was so fat when she bent down in Liverpool, they had an eclipse in Bournemouth. I would like tonight to play that song for you. It's a song which he wrote, as I say, as he lay tragically dying after falling headfirst into a bottle of malt whiskey after a permissive scrabble party in a Kilmarnock distillery. Now, we'll never know how much of the stuff he swallowed. But when he was cremated, it took a month to put the fire out. Well, so for all of you who thirst for culture, here is that song. Thank you. Then he died. I must say it's a great thrill to be in Scotland, home of mountains and glens and heather and Wembley turf. Let's face it, Scotland played well. The way England played, they were lucky to lose. And what a pleasure it is to be in Motherwell, appearing here in this thinly disguised knacker's yard. It's like a lampshade exhibition. If those pipes are anything to go by, I'd hate to see the bloody organs. Everybody said you must work on this Lena Martini show. No expense has been spared on this programme. And believe me, they've not spent a bloody penny on it. Those candles there are a job lot from a lapsed monk. Yeah. Look at those tablecloths, they're not really, you know, they're paper. They're all used samples from Kleenex. You want to see my dressing room? I'm not saying it's dirty, but you've got to spray it with DDT before the flies will come in. But I'll say one thing about the cheque that I received for this show. I'm going to take it straight round to the bank in the morning. I'll have to take it. It's too small to go on its own. The only reason I accepted this booking is because of one thing. Oh, I do fancy that Lena Martell. Oh, I'll give her a wee duck and dolly, I'll tell you. Knickers, knackers, knockers. Ooh, come for that. You can't get enough of it, that's the trouble. And I'm not getting anything. That's what's wrong. Oh, but what the hell, please, God, help me. Just what? That's what. Ooh. I thought it was the QE too. Sorry about that.
Hello, Les.
Hi.
May I say, it's great to be on the show, really.
Oh, yeah, yeah. It's been absolutely average having you here. Is this your first time in Scotland, Les?
No, I went to Glasgow about 9 years ago, but it was closed.
I've got to keep moving around the light fades address.
Yes, I must say, it's a lovely dress. It really is. If you ever found who made it, so no, it'll be very nice. I must say, Moira, it's a great pleasure to be here.
Well, thank you.
I think you're marvellous
in
Crossroads.
Thank you, Des. It was very...
Would you like me to play the piano for you? This is a song that was originally paged in Fort William. It's a song which is basically designed for people who fell yew trees. And the idea was the fastest, this is the Middle Ages, of course.
Of course.
When food and meat was scarce in particular.
Yeah, like now.
And the fastest man to fell a yew tree was given an old cat as a dinner. Hence the title of the song, I Sawed You Last Night and Got That Old Feline.
play the Scottish song.
It's something for his British.
Yes.
Oh, sure, I just love that. Well, this is the one I've been rehearsing.
Yes, yes.
Just smooth, isn't it?
Cosmo, all is forgiven.
If that's your attitude, I'm off, Moira.
Thank you very much. My next song, ladies and gentlemen, is one I recorded about 5 years ago, and it was recently reissued and was in the charts for about 4-5 months, and it has been requested, and I'm going to sing it because it's a favorite of mine. Thank you. Say goodbye.
all alone. There's no sense to life without you. Now all I do is just exist and think about the chance I've missed. To fake is not an easy task, and pride is such a foolish must. Let me try again. Let me try again. Think of all
goodbye, ladies and gentlemen. Before I do, I'd like to thank you for being here tonight. My guest, Les Dawson, the Brotherhood of Man, Brian Fay in the orchestra, Tony Mansell and the singers, Paul Horner, my personal accompanist. But most of all, you for spending this time with us. So until next week, take care.
It's time to say goodbye.
Thank you.
much to our surprise, the world had a different set of rules. We had to make our own way through life, learning what we could along the way. This is the world of everyday people. You have to understand your fellow man. When you love those everyday people, you make your way through life's eternal plan. Everyone knows the ways of the world, spinning in the circle of mankind, doing what others before us have done, learning what we can along the way.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. May I say, welcome. And as you know, with jet travel and Concorde, the world is getting smaller and smaller. Well, I personally would like very much to see the world get just a little younger. When the world fairy tales were always true. Every day was filled with laughter. Every day brought something new. Summertime seemed to last forever. Friends would come, friends would go, and the warmth would always linger on the days when time ran slow. A little younger. love was just a smile away. There was time for going fishing and the games we used to play. Ages, young lovers seem to always have a hard time having happy endings. I mean, look at poor old Romeo and Juliet. And of course, the path of true love never runs smooth, especially if you're a red Indian. How about this couple?
On the banks of the river, running bare, sweet Indian brave. On the other side of the river stood his lovely Indian maid. Little White Dove was her name. Such a lovely sight to see. But the tribes fought with each other.
Together.
Ladies and gentlemen, I feel that I am with friends tonight, and so much so that I have invited just a few more friends to be here tonight. And they are my friends, the New Seekers. Thank you.
Some friends along the way, but I need